Okay, I've never done this before. So what I'm doing actually is narrating a film that I've already done. All right, I rebuilt this countdown from... I was inspired by Ripple Training's Simple Countdown, and just went completely overboard with it. But it's extremely customizable, and as you can see, it has a choice of leading zeros and bad film. Not to mention your choice of fonts. So first thing you need to do is head on over into your generators, and if it's stored in SC generator, just select your countdown position in the timeline where you want to insert it and type W. You go into your home folder, movies, motion templates, generators, SC generator, simple counter, and into the media folder to get the sound effect and add it into your events. At the 2 second mark, you want to insert this, so turn on snapping, align the playhead, and drag the sound into the timeline and have it snap to the playhead. All right, that's if you want to insert the generator into your timeline. Now, various options allow you to place the generator as on a separate layer. And just go ahead and put the sound in real quick. And let's take a look at the features. Can change the circle colors, the to and from, with color one and color two. You don't see that right here, but I'll move the timeline real quick, and then you can see what the alternate colors are. You can switch the background. Let's just go with the gray, the line color for the crosshairs, it makes a good complement, the circle color, keep it as similar as to the line colors, the number color, you can change the opacity of the background to allow the video beneath to show through and create a tint. You can add a leading zero. You can adjust the font size so that whatever font you use will fit as you want it, and you can adjust the tracking and the vertical position so you can line it up. You can turn on and off a drop shadow. You have all the drop shadow controls. Opacity. The blur and the distance. And the angle. play through that a little bit. Go back up here and change to a different typeface. Give it a little bit of a psychedelic look. Adjust the controls. And we have bad film. And a number of controls, the focus, brightness amounts, saturation amounts, and variance. Scratches, scratch color, hairs and dust, jitter, and you can adjust the frequency of changes. Now, a low number will just create an occasional jitter and variance in effect. And high numbers will just keep that thing going like crazy. You can adjust randomness with the random seed generator. You can keyframe all of these properties as well. Let's play this through one last time. Okay, there you have it. I hope you enjoy it and have fun with it. It's just absolutely crazy.